Last statement to look at is the balance sheet and ratios associated with the balance sheet. Numbers, I say this later here too, numbers alone by themselves, just saying the numbers don't mean anything. And just giving sort of the textbook answer about this being a good coverage ratio or whatever, doesn't really mean that much either. It has to be specific to what that organization is trying to accomplish. There are some general rules of thumb, but we don't really go too much into the balance sheet analysis in this class, with a few exceptions. But I'll talk just briefly about it. Again, it's not something you necessarily focus on too much. I'm more interested in the income statement and the cash flow view than this. But you look at the capital view, it's essentially telling you, by looking at the balance sheet, how strong this company is if it's faced with having to take specific strategic actions in order to respond to marketplace stress, or to respond to economic downturns, or to respond to some sort of a strategic event. It tells you what assets are available to you to generate additional activities, and it also tells you how much borrowing capacity potentially, or equity raising capacity, some firm might have when situations require it. Essentially, how much resilience the organization would have to respond to external events. The banking crisis is a classic example where the banks were said to be undercapitalized because of the way they handled risk. One of the things that has brought about, at least for a while, is a refocus on understanding and make sure that the capital strength of an organization is an important element of understanding its strategic position. Just as an analogy, this is roughly the same. Talking about the balance sheet of a firm is roughly the same as, like, for a family, having enough money in the bank if there is a problem and you get laid off or you lose your job, that you could survive for a period of time paying the bills based upon the assets that have been accumulated. It's roughly the same situation. A firm runs into a difficult situation. How strong is their balance sheet in terms of moving forward in that direction? So you want to look at certain things. You want to look at, like, working capital. Firms need to have access to capital to keep the business going, make sure inventories continue, they can continue to do accounts receivable and the like. That's what these cash and liquidity ratios are all about. That is, if there is some reason that for some reason the revenue is under pressure for a period of time, maybe a storm, something like that, if it's a retail business like up in around this area, that there's enough material to keep the business operating, enough cash flow, enough in particular to pay the debts, which is what coverage ratios are about. If there is a problem, to make sure that the firm can continue to pay interest on its debts and doesn't go into default. Banks tend to have covenants or with bonds. When you borrow money, where there's certain ratios you have to keep in line. Most of the firms we deal with in our strategic analysis have very good balance sheets. We don't really have any cases that show, that I'm aware of at least, that it show a risk on the balance sheet. These are generally good firms that we deal with, strong, financially stable firms. A solid balance sheet means that capital is available. One of the things about the current capitalist market, current capital markets worldwide and in the U.S. in particular, is that capital generally is available to firms that are in a solid, attractive position, like the kinds of firms we're talking about. Capital is not, like it used to be, more of a scarce resource. You had to have a connection to get capital. Capital is much more open. So a firm that has good positions in its various assets and is able to achieve to borrow money with the right covenants can get access to capital. And there's some items here that you might pull out when you're doing an analysis. I don't really ask for them here, and I won't if you do want to add those analyses when you're looking at these various cases, the bottom line from a strategic perspective is, will this firm be in a position to acquire and utilize the capital it needs to take its strategic steps? If it wants to enter into an acquisition or a joint venture, it wants to make a direct investment in China, will it have access to the capital? Will it have access to, from a loan perspective, to cover its working capital? Will it have access to equity if it wants to make a large expansion or an acquisition? That's really the nature of the balance sheet perspective with respect to making arguments for or against the balance sheet as a impact on their strategic assessment and their strategic position.